Listen, Al Perez, I have beaten you umpteen times in the middle of the ring for a 1-2-3, and I think I should get the chance to become the World Heavyweight Champion.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another exciting hour of Pro Wrestling This Week. I'm Joe Pedicino.
And I'm Gordon Solie. During the next hour, we're going to have matches from around the world. We have an exclusive interview with Scotty McGhee as he continues to recover from the recent stroke that he suffered. Also, our Matt Classic goes back to 1966. We're going to see Bambi and Queen Kong in an arm wrestling contest. And we'll be hearing from Boni Blackstone in Sound Off and Bill Apter, of course, on the PWI report. But, Joe, we're going to start in Birmingham.
Gordon, our first stop today is in the Continental area. Nightmare Danny Davis has been having his problems with Dutch Mantell. The match we are about to see is between the two, but watch for the surprise that comes out of the wings.
Forget the rules, boy. Give him just what he's giving you. That's right. The way retaliatory measures, baby. It's time for him now. Put it to him, Dutch.
He's got no respect for the rules. Dutch don't need to have none either.
There's that short lariat used by Dutch Mantell that he uses so very effectively. He's put a lot of men out of the match with that.
Stable number one. Hear him cheering out there, Gordon. They're all hollering. Stable number one. Stable number one. Listen to him, Jimmy.
Yep.
That's for us, baby.
You know, I'd say that man right there is in serious trouble now, Danny Davis. Dutch Mantell's got a claw on him, boy.
Now, ripping across the face once again of Danny Davis. Davis retaliating. Davis scoring with a hard right hand.
Jimmy, something's got to be done about those fists.
Wow! Man. Mantell went straight into a foot.
Danny Davis has turned this one around, Gordon.
He sure has, Charlie. Danny Davis brings him up. Full body slam. Looks to me.
Look at the fist, Gordon. Look at him pounding him in the face with a fist. And where's the referee at? He's not doing a dang thing about it. Get busy, referee. Tell him what's happening, Jimmy.
Davis moves to one side. Davis outside now. Ringing the bell. A disqualification here. Look at this. Golden coming off the ropes now. Mantell and Golden both pounding away on the Nightmare.
The Wildcat is back.
Boy, he is indeed. Wildcat Wendell Cooley is back in action, and man, he came out of nowhere. He's got Dutch Mantell in a world of hurt now. All right, Mantell has been disqualified, but now they're double-teaming on Cooley.
Davis goes over the top rope.
We've got more problems here. As now they're up to Wildcat Wendell Cooley. Hold on. The Southern boys just hit the ring. We've got to get some kind of order restored.
Well, as we saw just a few minutes ago, Wildcat Wendell Cooley is back in the ring. And if I were Dutch Mantell, I think I'd be very careful in the future. Right now, Gordon, we are headed to Memphis.
We are indeed. And we're going to see Maxx Pain and Gary Young going up against the Bruise Brothers. Now, Pain and Gary Young are managed by Brother Ernst. And in this case, it's carrying the good book too far.
What about it, Brother Lance? What do you think?
He's big and he's rugged and all of the other good adjectives go with it. I just wish that all of your guys had a little more respect for the rules.
Go ahead there, Brother Young, and show them. That's it. One more time.
Interference from outside on the apron. Double teaming, choking, right fist.
Well, they're fixing the tag. They're fixing the tag.
Yeah. What about all the other things?
Well, just, you know.
Here Maxx Pain walking around. Finally, he power slams him. 303
pounds. I wish the camera could get a close-up of that boy's face. That's it. Now, look here, Brother Pain. Here we go. Here we go.
Top rope. Look at that. Top rope. And Maxx Pain throws him over there, and Ron Bassett moved out of the way.
No.
Ron needs that tag. He's not too far away from the corner. Is he going to make the tag? You got it.
Uh-oh. I don't think so. He'll get over and tag Brother Pain. It's all over with. Look at him taking advantage of him like that. That's not very fair. Do you think, Brother Dave?
Taking advantage?
I think they are.
It looks like one against one to me, and it looks like Don Bruce is really working over gorgeous Gary Young. It looks like if Gary Young obeys the rules, Don Bruce has got the upper hand. Bruce snaps him into the ropes.
Well,
Gary Young in trouble here.
I believe they need to make a tag here. Oh, me. Y'all are going to have to pardon me. I believe they need my help over there at ringside. Y'all are going to have to pardon me there, Brother Russell. Y'all excuse me just a minute.
Yeah, well, just make certain that the help
don't
is
interfere
only verbal.
Stay out of it.
Brother Ernest Angel going over to ringside to counsel with his boys.
Oh, yeah, there's
counsel.
Help.
Uh-huh.
There's help.
He just took that good book of his and he slammed Bruce right in the head with it. Gary Young gets a 1-2-3, and they're going to end up with a victory.
I don't think that's what they mean by the book, and Brother Ernest had best be careful in the future. Our international match comes from Calgary, Canada. We've had a lot of questions wanting to know where Rip Rogers is. Well, we're going to watch a match between Mr. Hito and Kerry Brown, and Rip Rogers is at ringside.
It's a fight that has been really dominated by Brown. He's choking. Herman is helpless to make a move to find out if it's going on. And when he gets there, of course, the choking has stopped. He's going to hang him. Ouch.
Ooh, that'll increase the size of the old shirt collar. Our timekeeper, Tommy Carr, just tells us we passed the 10-minute mark, and it has been 9.5 minutes of Kerry Brown and maybe about a half a minute of retaliation by Mr. Hito.
I bet you guys didn't know that Kerry Brown was second place, Mr. Canada. You didn't know that, did you?
What is this? Rip Rogers is yelling in my ear that Kerry Brown was second place in the Mr. Canada contest.
First place, I think, went to the Stay Puffed Marshmallow Boy.
Well, Hito staging a rally. Brown forgets he's not in a tag match. Look out. Oh, my. Oh, my. Is he wrapped up now?
And Kerry Brown, as soon as he saw Mr. Hito, hung up on the ropes, went to work, pulls him up by the hair. You're not going to see a lot of finesse. It's all brute strength by Kerry Brown. Drives the shoulder into his knee. Now it looks like off the second rope is going to come Kerry Brown. Catches him with a big elbow. 1, 2, 3.
It appears that Rip Rogers has taken young Kerry Brown under his wing, and that doesn't bode real well for the fan favorites in Calgary. And, of course, we'll be bringing you up to date on that situation right here each week. Right now, though, it's an interview, a continuation of the interview with Scotty McGhee.
Yeah, we had an opportunity to go back and talk to Scotty once again. Of course, he suffered a stroke about 8 weeks ago. And Scotty continues to improve. However, the future is still in doubt. But let's go to Scotty McGhee's home in Tampa.
Scotty, since you had the blood clot on the brain that's now dissolved, you've regained about what percentage of your speech?
About 75%.
Okay, how about the right side?
Well, my arm is about 25%, and my leg is, I'd say, about 50%.
All right, so at this point in time, though, you can't run at all, can you?
No, unfortunately not.
Now, when you first came out of the hospital, I understand that your right leg was still dragging.
Yeah, that's true. Whole side had paralysis.
All right, now, I understand now that you're back in Tampa that your old trainer and mentor, Carl Gotch, is working with you.
Yes, sir, he is, and he's giving me a rubber ball. I'm squeezing it and things like that.
Okay, and your dad is coming over from Germany, of course, originally from England, but coming over from Germany?
Yeah, he'll be coming in about a week, and he'll be around.
Any thoughts as to how soon you might return to wrestling?
As yet, there's, unfortunately, there's no answer yet. No answer yet.
Well, I know all of you join us in wishing Scotty a very, very speedy recovery. His dad is with him now, and of course, he's working out with Carl Gotch almost on a daily basis, and I look for a total recovery.
That would be good for Scotty. We've got our Matt Classic coming up. It features the Stomper. We'll be back with that right after this timeout.
As Pro Wrestling This Week continues, we move back 22 years in time. As we go to a Calgary Classic, we're going to watch the Stomper taking on Dan Kroffat. And this one is a dandy.
He's got him down on that deck. He's squeezing him. It's very close. The referee hit Dan Kroffat. Referee hit Kroffat. What's going on here? Stomper pulled the referee over Kroffat. Kroffat hit him on the head. Now the Stomper gets up and goes to work with a boot. Well, what do you know? One, two, and this crowd is irate. This crowd is really irate. Somehow I sense your victory isn't too popular.
Let me tell you something. I told Dan Kroffat and I told all these other punks that there's no man in this world gonna stop me from getting that world belt. That world heavyweight wrestling belt is going to be mine. It's going to be mine because I have earned a reputation to meet the world heavyweight champion. And like I said, nobody is going to stop me, and nobody did.
Well, you told me you've beaten him three times.
That's right. Here comes the man that I have beat three times when he was a U.S. champion. There he is.
That's three
right.
times.
That's right. You know, it never. It never hurts to have an edge. To have an edge on a man like this man. I've got my edge now.
Of course, there at the end, you saw the man who was to become seven times NWA World Champion, Harley Race, all as part of our Mac Classic. Talking about a classic, it will be one on March 27th at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, Trump Plaza in Atlantic City, when the WWF presents WrestleMania 4. More news this week. Let's go to our update with Craig DeGeorge.
And of course, in a battle royal, you are eliminated if you're thrown over the top rope. The winner, the last one remaining in the ring. With the rules now aside, let's go to some of the Battle Royal participants.
WrestleMania 4. For more, the Russo Brothers with an invitation to the big Battle Royal.
You know Atlantic City, the city you could bet. Well, you could bet your bottom dollar we're going there to win. Yeah! Damn, Mick Benson, baby. There's going to be 20 people in the ring. And you know something? The Big Outlaw, he shines because I like to fight. I like to throw people out. And you better believe on WrestleMania 4, that's what me and Miss Benson's doing. We're going to throw them here. We're going to throw them out. And we'll be the last one standing.
Battle Royal, this is not going to be no Battle Royal. This is a Harlem picnic, Harlem barbecue style. And I'm going to bring my reign of terror to the ring.
King, I'll show you why I'm called the King. When I walk into the Battle Royal, I'll walk in as King. And when I leave, I will be the last. That King, the King will prevail in the Battle Royal.
You know, in a Battle Royal, you've got to have a lot of guts. But at the Heart Foundation, we've got something more than everyone else got.
We've got a lot of heart.
Something we all pride ourselves on. Top of the class.
This is it. We finally did it. WrestleMania 4. The Young Stallions are going to be there. We're going to give it all we got.
That's right. WrestleMania 4. We're going to be galloping right through, right to the top.
Well, obviously, the WrestleMania 4 is going to be another history-making event in professional wrestling. No question about that. Our congratulations to the WWF.
That's right, and you know, a big part will be that six-man tag, including the British Bulldogs and the return of Matilda. Let's take a look at the British Bulldogs now in action as they go up against Brian Costello and Terry Gibbs.
We'll look forward to reading all about Matilda's participation this Tuesday in the WWF magazine. Matilda is talking about sinking her teeth into the six-man brawl.
Yeah, she may do that, but I want to know this training Matilda's being put through. What kind of, what is this, attack training or what?
I don't know, Jesse. I mean, all I know, it's kind of specialized, if you know what I mean.
You know, there's no place for vicious animals in a cultured society.
No?
That's right.
Davey Boy in control over Costello. Nice suplex. Capacity crowd looking on at the British Bulldogs thus far are showing you all about tag team coordination. Dynamite in control. Costello up. Boom!
Wow,
bouncing off the knee.
Vicious backbreaker right there by the Dynamite Kid.
What a matchup that's going to be. Heenan in the ring for the first time in over. Look at that. Whoa! Costello at Bronzeville. I just can't imagine what Coco and the Bulldogs are going to do with Bobby the Brain Heenan. Sleeper hold! Costello trying to fight it off. From the top rope, look at that! Gets stuck to the second rope!
And Costello's in real trouble now. He doesn't even have a partner to tag if he could get there.
There's a legal tag for you. And watch out, Costello now. And look out for more. Here comes the Dynamite Kid!
Well, I'll tell you what, Joe, it's time to take a look at the ratings, and inasmuch as we're in the WWF for the moment, let's stay with them.
Well, we'll take a look at our list of champions. We've got the WWF ratings and a look at our thumbs up. Welcome back to Pro Wrestling This Week. You know, Gordon, recently in Southern Championship Wrestling, one of the wildest matches I have ever seen took place.
It did indeed. It took place at Miss Kitty's in Marietta, Georgia. Randy Rose and the wild man from the Sudan, Abdullah the Butcher, teamed up to take on the very popular Chick Donovan and Steve Prichard. Anytime Abdullah the Butcher is in the area, you know something unexpected is going to happen.
The referee is tolling the count, but I don't know where this is headed. They've thrown Steve Prichard back in the ring. Oh, outside the ring, Randy Rose has body slammed Chick Donovan, while inside the ring, Abdullah the Butcher has been demolishing Steve Prichard. We have chaos here at Miss Kitty's again this week. They're using TV equipment. Wait a minute. Abdullah the Butcher reached into his boot. He pulls out. He's got something in his hand, and he jams it into the throat of Chick Donovan. Randy Rose and Abdullah the... Wait a minute. Put the camera on Randy Rose. Oh, goodness. Randy Rose just did a suplex, a full suplex, on Steve Prichard outside the ring. The referee is going to have to do something. This is not... This cannot be called a match. I don't know what's going on. Abdullah the Butcher, and he runs Steve Prichard into our monitor.
Oh no, it's a case of beer.
Abdullah the Butcher.
There's broken glass everywhere. There's broken glass everywhere, Joe.
Man, you're going to have to excuse us. This is unbelievable. They have used everything but the kitchen sink on these two men. They've used
chairs. Well,
oh, the referee is tolling a three count. The referee has tolled a three count.
Wait, it looks like Abdullah the Butcher is not through yet, Joe. He's got the beer.
Well, Abdullah used everything except the kitchen sink, and doggone near got the monitor. Time now to move on to the world-class championship wrestling in a match between Al Perez and Terry Taylor. However, it's a match that's not a match. There was so much interference that, basically it sort of speaks for itself. Let's go to Texas.
Here comes Terry Gordy now. Adam said he'll fool with Taylor later. He wants a shot at the belt. Here's Terry Gordy. A shot on Adams, and now Hart tries to separate Taylor and Perez, protecting the champion from who is supposed to be the official man. Look out, Terry Gordy wants the Oriental spike, and he's got it on Chris Adams. Here comes Kerry Von Erich. Kerry Von Erich goes after Perez, who tried to stop him when he got in the ring. Kerry with a discus run, and out goes Perez. Terry Taylor staying around Kerry. Now he backs away. Here comes Gordy. And Kerry wants to throw him out. And he does so. Kerry is out after Terry Gordy. Al Perez is getting Gary, is leaving by the hand of Gary Hart's what I'm trying to say. Hart ushering him out to protect him. Gordy and Kerry are at it on the floor. It looks like Terry Taylor is trying to help Chris Adams in the ring. A bad scene with Gordy and Kerry, but it looks like a good scene.
Ready, Skip, we can go up. Ready?
Adams. Remember the Bad Street match we saw the conclusion of earlier. Helps us to understand why Kerry and Gordy are at it. Hey! Terry Taylor just punched Chris Adams. Taylor evidently was decoying everybody. Pile driver.
waiting for the right moment to get a shot on Chris Adams. Oh, it's ugly seeds a pair.
A wild situation in world class. Luckily, the officials were able to get it under control, but it does show us that Terry Taylor really has not changed. One of the most asked questions we get here at PWTW, how do I become a wrestler or a valet? Boni Blackstone has her answer in Sound Off this week.
Our first question today comes to us from Paula D. of Hampton, Georgia, who watches pro wrestling this week every Saturday morning on WATL, Atlanta's 36. Paula wants to ask, how can I get into professional wrestling as a valet, manager, or commentator? I've often been told that I'm pretty enough, but I don't know whom to contact about making the move into a major league promotion. Well, Paula, if you're serious about wanting to become a valet or manager and not just clowning around about it, there are several schools in the United States that can teach you the skills necessary to get into the wrestling business. Since you live in the Atlanta, Georgia area, we suggest the Southern Championship Wrestling Training Center, run by Southern Championship Wrestling. At the Southern Training Center, real professional wrestlers and valets can help you decide if you have what it takes to become a real valet or manager. You can contact the promoters of Southern Championship Wrestling to find out about their next class. You might also want to check around your area to find other good training centers. Our next letter is very similar to Paula's and comes to us from gorgeous John E. of Arlington, Texas. John wants to know the name of a school near him where he can further his skills and become a full-time professional wrestler. John, you don't say what kind of training you've already had, but obviously you don't feel that it's enough. One of the top schools in the country is located near you in Dallas, Texas. Once again, experienced wrestlers work with the students to help them further their careers and become true professional wrestlers. Contact the World Class Training Academy about more training and good luck on your pursuit of a professional wrestling career. That's it for our Where Do I Begin segment of Sound Off. If you have a question about wrestling or a comment, send it to me here. Until next time, I'm Boni Blackstone.
Thank you very much, Boni, and we look forward to another Sound Off next week. Right now, we are going to take a look at the WWA.
That's right. Of course, formerly the Central States wrestling area, we're going to watch Gentleman Ken Timms, who is anything but that, going up against an FSU graduate, Vinny Valentino. Valentino's an outstanding athlete, and this is quite a match.
Continuing to work on the back,
though. Lower back, what's that lower back? Is that you don't have any strength, it drains the rest of your body. It's just like working on a leg or lower back. When they're gone, you don't have anything left.
Yeah, when they're gone, you're gone, exactly. Vinny trying to mount a comeback here. Tim's continuing to work on the back. But you know, Dave, you know Vinny, there's no quitting. Dave, he's got him covered.
Didn't even have the strength to slam him.
No, but, you know, he's out there. You know, Vinny gives 100% every time he steps in the ring. Tonight, no exception as usual.
Oh!
Both men find himself down on the mat.
I've often wondered how a lot of wrestlers wrestle barefooted, but it has its advantages, as you can see. He can run them toes. Right in there.
And I think he just did that. And quite a few times it looked like it. Catches him in the face. Timms is down. Vinny's got that second win, Dave. He's got it now. He's telling Timms to get up.
Timms don't want to get up very bad, but he
But he was forcibly made into it.
Whoa.
I know he felt that one. Vinny, flying head scissors. You know, Vinny can use the aerial wrestling like very few can. Catches him again.
And Vinny's what, 250?
He's up there. He's about 240, but he's a solid 240, much like yourself. Caught him with that knee. Wait a minute. He's got the three count. I don't know if the camera's got a shot of it. I saw Kim Kemp with his foot on the rope the way I saw it.
What the hell's going on here?
One, two, three, that's it.
Your winner of this match. Your winner of this match from Georgia, gentlemen, Kim Kemp.
Wait a minute. After the match, Ken Timms continued to pound. All right, according to referee Sonny Myers, he has reversed the decision because of Ken Timms. continued his beating on Vinny after the match.
Reverse decision.
More action coming your way now on Pro Wrestling This Week as we move to the Pacific Northwest. Mike Miller is taking on the Avalanche. Miller gets an opportunity to show some style.
Hey, I'm telling you, the excitement throughout the Pacific Northwest in professional wrestling has never been so electrifying. Man, I've never seen it so electrifying, you understand? March 5th, like I said, world title held up, AWA world title held up. Grappler and Kurt Hennig. Who will be the champion? It all remains to be seen on March 5th. Then next Saturday night, Mean Mike Miller against the Grappler, Pacific Northwest title on the line. Determination again, Mean Mike Miller's got it.
And here comes Miller. Oh, man, he just leveled the Avalanche. He just laid a landslide on the Avalanche.
Mike Miller now pulling through here. Let's see what he does. Oh, what a...
Woo! Oh. And Avalanche is down. Now, he was just clothesline, Miller style. And now Mike Miller just bearing those fists into the stomach of Avalanche, taking the wind right out of him. Now he's working on the head, the forehead. Sandy Barr trying to keep him back. And I don't know. I don't think you're not going to get anywhere with those two guys where they're going at each other right now. Avalanche coming back with another hard forearm smash right across the top of the head. Now, wait a minute. What's Avalanche got? He's got something in his hand. He's got some brass knuckles in his hand. He's got brass knuckles in his hands, Assassin.
Oh, no. But Miller, wait a minute. Miller got him one.
Oh, he can't.
One, two.
No. Avalanche is getting those shoulders up there. Avalanche is a doggone big. He can't keep his shoulders down.
What is that?
Those are brass knucks. The Avalanche had him, and now Miller's got him.
Oh, no. What's going to happen here?
Mike Miller has got those brass knuckles that Avalanche found.
Oh, wait a minute. One, two, three. Mike Miller got him.
He's got it. Absolutely. He put the fear of brass knuckles in him. And the match belongs to Mike Miller. Yes, sir. Over Avalanche.
Combination, man. Did you see that?
Mike Miller showing a lot of class in that particular match in the Great Northwest. Now then, time to hear from our good friend, the senior editor of Pro Wrestling Illustrated, Bill Apter. Bill Apter has some interesting editorial comments regarding the Rock and Roll Express and the Fantastics. Bill?
Today, let's talk about the Rock and Roll Express leaving the NWA. As you know, it was a shock to everybody. They're out of the National Wrestling Alliance, and they've been replaced in the NWA by the Fantastics. Now, how does this affect both teams? Well, let's take a look at the record. The Rock and Roll Express, as